What your neurons are trying to do is get you to pay attention. Here you've discovered this unexpected reward, this unexpected squirt of apple juice. Where did it come from? Maybe there's a pattern there you can find, in which case you'll be able to predict it farther in advance and maybe get some more. You know, it's trying to grab your attention, make you pay attention so you'll find the reward. Every once in a while, you put in a quarter and you get a bunch of quarters in return. The lights go off, the coins clang. It's a very exciting thing. Your dopamine neurons are titillated. You know, very titillated, precisely because it's surprising. And so they generate this large surge of dopamine, try to grab your attention, try to get you to find the pattern that predicts this reward, so that the surprising reward is no longer surprising, so you can maximize. Your dopamine neurons, these dumb little cells, they'll never find the thing that predicts the clanging coins and the sirens going off, because it's just a random number generator in the slot machine. There is nothing to predict. But, of course, your dopamine neurons don't know that. No one's told them about Las Vegas or Atlantic City or Racino's in West Virginia. So they keep on generating these certs. So every time you get a reward, you generate the same surprising squirt of dopamine. It's like getting a surprising squirt of juice. And your dopamine neurons can never adapt.
Over the course of time, we have built neurological pathways in our brain that were not there when we were born. It's sort of like a freeway that's always going to be there. We can develop ways from getting from point A to point B anew. We can develop a new freeway to make ourselves feel good. We can develop ways to sort of not go down that old path called gambling. But can we ever eliminate it? I don't think so.
Groupings of neurons in the brain are involved in the release of neurotransmitters in the synapses. In schizophrenia, there is evidence of hyperactivity of the dopaminergic DA systems. Overproduction in the dopaminergic neurons in the substantia nigra stimulate the nigrostriatal tracts. The mesolimbic dopaminergic tracts now receive a supply of dopamine from the ventral tegmental area. As a result, this influences the processes of the limbic system, amygdaloid body, parahippocampal area, and frontal lobe. This wide distribution of excessive dopamine helps to explain the variety of symptoms seen in schizophrenia. Negative symptoms include flat affect, alocia, disorganized thought and speech, anhedonia, lack of pleasure, avolition, decreased motivation, inattention, and self-care deficits.
The whole theme of today is to free our minds. It actually is more than that, as I'll come to. Free our minds from the programming that turns infinite consciousness having an experience into a four-legged animal from which we get wool, that have lost the ability to decide perception and reality for themselves. A state of anxiety, I've seen people in it, state of anxiety when their belief system and their experience or what they're hearing in terms of information are at odds.
You know, stress over time can cause irritability, anxiety, agitation, depression. The less common effects that I think people forget about are problems with concentration, trouble making decisions, constant worry, or loss of sense of humor.
Some of these people could have been doctors, nurses, teachers, community workers. But the fact remains is that there is always still a percentage of our community that are lost, that haven't got their mind free. That's not to say that they can't do that, because we can.
There are 8 betting shops on this 300-metre stretch of High Street and 37 across the whole of Tottenham. There's not a single bookshop in the whole of my constituency. What sort of message does that send to our young people? We need a change in legislation that allows communities to say enough's enough. This isn't about the rights and wrongs of gambling, but it is about empowering local communities to have a say in their local area.
If we're correct and the inappropriate control of the dopamine transporter is a part of what is happening in ADHD, we have to remember that other behaviors and other behavioral disorders have long been studied for a contribution of dopamine to them. Bipolar disorder and mania particularly, and schizophrenia, for example. Schizophrenia is treated with drugs that can block the actions of dopamine.
Transcend the victorious chariot of earthly manifestation. Travel to infinity, riding the wave of the eight keys. Past, present, future. Shifting perspective to allow transformation into light. Follow the shine of the cosmic hermit, leaving behind, go beyond. Take seat in the next ride of the wheel.
You know, we have a vampire, you know, coming to the community and sucking out the community. And we can't do nothing about it. You know, I feel it. Because this is my community.
Anybody who's looked into the facts of gambling knows that advertising has an influence on children.
The main trade of bookmakers is with fixed odds betting terminals. These are gaming machines that allow you to play casino games at casino stakes at three times the speed. They are highly addictive, allowing users to place stakes of £100 a time.
The pace of the games is three times faster to five times faster than it is in a casino for the same table game content. The rules of the game are not as fair as they are in the casino games. The result's already been predetermined. So players think, I've got a near miss one more time, and it's the near misses that for addicts are just as exciting as wins.
I didn't think that that would carry on into my everyday life, and that that would involve itself in my social interactions and the way I saw the world. And it wasn't just down to the actual mistakes of losing money, it was my brain becoming affected.
It was in this park in South Manchester that it all ended for primary school head teacher, husband and father of two, John Riley. Mr. Riley's addiction to gambling, he mainly used online casino sites, resulted in the family's home in Stockport being repossessed. In June this year, John Riley came here to Withenshaw Park and hanged himself. Manchester coroner Nigel Meadows recorded a verdict of suicide during an inquest into the death of head teacher John Riley. Mr. Meadows said the case illustrated just how gambling was as dangerous as drugs are in our society, and said that it could lead to relationship and family breakdown.
They asked me whether I wanted to take part in a review of gambling law that was taking place in the UK. And so the chair said, we're going to ask people for evidence, we're going to set some questions, and we should all have a courtesy of reading all the evidence that comes in. So I thought, yes, of course, if people are going to the trouble of writing evidence, then we should read it. So anyway, the deadline went and came, and the evidence arrived, and I put it in a pile that came up to my waist, roughly speaking. And every gambling company had employed PR consultants to send evidence in, and we probably got about 150 submissions. Many of these were bound, 150 page treatises on gambling law and how things should be changed. So what were we doing as a country or as an academic community to study the problems of gambling or the nature of gambling? Well, in the course of our report, we found that when we started, There was a pilot study in Sheffield funded by the NHS for about £25,000 looking at problem gambling. Within a few months, we got a letter saying actually the NHS had pulled the plug on this and had stopped. And that was the only public money we could find in the country going into studying gambling at all. So there were half a dozen academics, but most of them were funded by the gambling industry one way or another, or were funded just out of university resources, out of QR money. So there was no research going on of any significance in gambling in the UK.